If you work with meds, you have to know anticholinergic side effects. You have to know what medicines give anticholinergic side effects, like atropine, like Benadryl, some of the antipsychotics. Anticholinergic side effects are someone who's blind as a bat. Their pupils will dilate. They won't be able to see. Someone who's mad as a hatter, they'll be delusional. They will be dry as a bone. Okay? They'll be dried up. They will be red as a beet, and they will be hot. A couple pearls about this. Interestingly, when I was in Desert Storm, we went into Kuwait. We had in our medical kit, we were taking Cipro for anthrax, but we had to carry atropine with us, and I didn't understand why. My thought was, if we died, are we going to try to speed up our heart? No, we were using atropine as a drying agent. Because if you got hit with an organophosphate, it's like bug spray. What happens is you start weeping from all your orifices, your eyes, your nose, lacrimation, salivation, defecation. But you'll fill your lungs. Your lungs will fill with bronchorrhea, just mucus. And the atropine was to be used to dry it up so you don't drown. Okay. Also of an interesting anticholinergic overdose or side effect, I had 2 9-year-olds that came into the ER the one time, boy and girl. Mom was the boy, the girl she was watching. Chief complaint was, my kids ate something in my car and I don't know what it is, but they're not acting right. And I'm thinking, this is silly. I'm too busy to deal with silliness. So I go in, and one of the tricks I would do all the time to tell if a kid is appropriately stimulated by the environment, I will take a SpongeBob sticker, put it on my forehead, and go into the room. Hi, my name's John. I'm the physician assistant. I was going to bring you a sticker, but I can't find it. And I asked the nurse, do you know what the SpongeBob sticker is? And so, no, John, I don't know where it is. And I go in with a sticker, and I'm looking for the kids to go, dude, it's on your head. And right away I can say, they're appropriately responding to the environment, okay? Hi, my name's John. I'm the physician assistant. What's going on? And the kids looked at me like this. They went, I'm like, both of them did that. They both kind of looked at me. They stared off. I'm like, they're sick. I'm like, wait, mom, what did you have in the car? She says, well, I had some brake fluid and I had some stuff. And I'm like, wait, did you drive the car here? She says, no, I took another car. So I'm like, these people are sick. They have these pupils that are like, oh! Okay, and their heart's racing and they're dry. And I'm like, this is an anticholinergic overdose. So I got poison control involved in Children's Hospital and I started giving them charcoal. I'm like, mom, what was in the car? I called the sheriff's department. I said, listen, I want you to go to this address. I want you to break into the car if you have to and bring me everything that was in the car. So the sheriffs get there and the sheriffs pull mom aside and moms get tearful. And then mom admits that she laced gummy worms with PCP. And the kids found them in the car. So these kids were on a PCP overdose and they were an anticholinergic toxidrome from PCP overdose.